We have a stark opportunity before us right now. We're fortunate enough to be funded by NIH, actually, to explore a vaccine approach for human rotavirus. We're also currently funded by Morris Animal Foundation to develop a coronavirus vaccine for cats. And that's what also made it very easy for us to pivot and address the human coronavirus. Our approach has been to utilize a common probiotic bacterium that a lot of people know and love. It's Lactobacillus acidophilus. You'll find it in yogurt, you'll find it in a lot of products, cheese, and it actually interacts with you. So we're putting our vaccine right at the tissue where we want to induce the immune response. And then we're using these very select regions from the virus to induce an antibody response that we believe can disrupt transmission. Viruses are amazing, and they have their ways of evading the host immune response. But we think these two sites in particular, if we can block their function, will disrupt that virus's ability to enter the cell. And if we can inhibit that function, really it represents an Achilles heel for the virus. And that's how we intend and hope that we'll interrupt transmission. Every vaccine attempt really is a moonshot. We're going to do our best with our strategy. We're really hopeful that it might work. But we have to also be realistic. We need a lot of people working hard with different approaches to try to address this problem. We're fortunate to have such a depth and breadth of expertise here at CSU. And you look across the board and you'll find investigators working on vaccines, on antivirals, on diagnostic strategies. We, as a group here at CSU, really, we're trying to tackle this problem from every angle we can. The current situation is dire. I think every scientist who toils in the laboratory hopes that they'll ultimately be able to have a tangible impact on human and or animal health.